Hello everyone and welcome back to this course that is History of Microsoft Dynamics 365. In this video we will see the detailed course content. This course that is History of Microsoft Dynamics 365 by Dynamics Academy is mainly divided into 9 modules, where in module number 1 we will see the origin and roadmap of Microsoft Dynamics 365 from its first officially released version till date. Where first I will introduce you to what is Microsoft Dynamics 365, then we will see the history of Microsoft Dynamics 365 and we'll get the details about pre-CRM, that means what was there before CRM was officially launched, and in the end we will see the roadmap of Microsoft Dynamics 365 from its first officially released version till date. And then in module number 2 we will see the major features that were released in Microsoft CRM 1.0 and 1.2. Where first I will introduce you to what is Microsoft CRM 1.0 and 1.2. Then we will see the detailed functionalities and the new features that were released in Microsoft CRM 1.0, along with the limitations of Microsoft CRM 1.0 and what forced Microsoft to launch its updated version in the same year, that is Microsoft CRM 1.2. What were the key changes that were done from its earlier version, and at the end we will see a brief conclusion about this module. Then in module number 3, we will see the major changes in Microsoft Dynamics CRM 3.0, where first I will introduce you to Microsoft Dynamics CRM 3.0. Then we will see what were the improvements and changes that were done from its earlier version, and along with that, what were the new features and some brief limitations of Microsoft Dynamics CRM 3.0. And at the end, we will conclude this module as well. And then in module number 4, we will see major changes in Microsoft Dynamics CRM 4.0, where first I will introduce you to Microsoft Dynamics CRM 4.0, and after that we will see the improvements and changes that were done in Microsoft Dynamics CRM 4.0, along with the new features and the limitations of Microsoft Dynamics CRM 4.0, and at the end we will conclude this module as well. And in module number 5 we will see the key major changes in Microsoft Dynamics CRM 2011. From here, the nomenclature was different from its earlier versions. Where first, I will introduce you to the Microsoft Dynamics CRM 2011, and then we will see the improvements and changes that were done on Microsoft Dynamics CRM 2011, along with the new features and limitations of Microsoft Dynamics CRM 2011. And at the end, we will conclude this module as well. And similarly, in module number 6, also, we will see the major changes in Microsoft Dynamics CRM 2013. Where I will first introduce you to Microsoft Dynamics CRM 2013, and then we will see the improvements and changes along with the new features of Microsoft Dynamics CRM 2013, and in the end we will see the limitations and we'll briefly conclude this module as well. In module number 7 we will see the major changes in Microsoft Dynamics CRM 2015, where I will first introduce you to Microsoft Dynamics CRM 2015, and then we will see the improvements and new features along with the limitations of Microsoft Dynamics CRM 2015, and at the end we will conclude this module as well. And likewise in module number 8 we will see the major changes in Microsoft Dynamics CRM 2016, where first I will introduce you to Microsoft Dynamics CRM 2016, and then we will see the improvements in Microsoft Dynamics CRM 2016. After that we will see the new features, and at the end we will see the limitations and a brief conclusion about this module as well. That is module number 9, we will see the major changes in Microsoft Dynamics 365, which is the current latest version of Microsoft Dynamics family of products. Where first I will introduce you to Microsoft Dynamics 365, then what were the key platform improvements and the changes done in Microsoft Dynamics 365, along with the new features that were released with Microsoft Dynamics 365. And at the end we will conclude about this module and we'll have a brief conclusion overall about this course as well. So this course has something to offer for everyone, be it a fresher or an experienced professional. So from my experience, I highly recommend you to complete this course, and also share this course with your friends who wants to learn about Microsoft Dynamics 365, which is one of the hottest and latest and trending technology in the market today. So on that note, I will wind up this lecture. In our next video, we will see the target audience and prerequisites before taking up this course. So I hope to see you all in the next lecture. Thank you and bye-bye.